river now at night, 12 o'clock at night. The boat runs up and down the river to see if there's any nets in the river.
Did they watch our friends that come into Frank's Landing? They're watching us with binoculars from across the river.
They said that, oh, they're no good for nothing now. We have no more treaty.
The state could come and take my boat, motor, and all my fish, and myself, and haul us all to jail. It's been 4 years now since some of my gear has been confiscated, and I haven't got it back yet.
Yeah, taking everything we've had. So it looks like we just have to quit fishing. If we want to eat fish, buy fish off of the white man, yeah.
We fishing down here at Frank's Landing. This was a demonstration to put the problem before the public.
Just took over the Indian scene, you might say.
We decided we would put our boats on the opposite side of the river to minimize the mingling with the huge crowd of Indians and newspaper people that was there. And when we went across the river, they started throwing clubs, and so we had to bring in our full force and arrest anyone who had resisted or interfered with us in the performance of our duty.
I was on the jury of the case when the state of Washington was versing the Nisqually Indian. Well, they testified that to their belief, weapons carried.
There was no weapons in any of them that made an arrest there.
And still, these pictures prove the fact that some of the Game Department officials that got on the stand and testified had weapons in their possession and used them.
They have billy clubs. They have billy clubs made out of lead pipe.
The only people that was hurt was our own people. There was no Indian people hurt at all.
I came upon one game warden, and he had my two nieces by the hair, and he was pounding one of their faces into a log, and...
The fight goes on. The Indians won that case. But now Al Bridges and his family are on their way to court, charged yet again with illegal fishing. In the state capitol, they will wear, as they always do, traditional dress.
Can you remember the time that you have held your head high and told all your friends of your Indian claim? Proud good lady and proud good man, your great-great-grandfather from Indian blood sprang, and you feel in your heart for these ones. Oh, it's written in book and in song.
And not abiding by state conservation laws left hardly enough fish to spawn. Inspired by the Black Civil Rights Movement, individuals like Robert Satiacum, Billy Frank Jr., and Hank Adams formed the Survival of the American Indians Association and staged fish-in protests, thereby defying state laws but exercising their treaty rights. As the confrontations got worse in the 1960s, celebrities and other civil rights organizations got involved.
Well, we don't plan only to fish. We also plan some legal maneuvers to carry the issues in certain courts and as high as we can go. We think that there are evolving some issues of international import relating to Indian tribes of various American nations.
The increased public attention and the Bureau of Indian Affairs convinced the United States on behalf of itself and seven tribes to file a case against the state of Washington in September 1970, U.S. v. Washington.
And then there's Herman Johns, better known as Curley, another of Bill Frank's grandchildren. This is the family that lives at Frank's Landing. During the summer, they work at various jobs, frequently in neighboring berry fields and tree farms. But when autumn comes and the salmon start running, Bill Frank's family, like all their ancestors, set their nets for fish. They In 1968, the survival organization enlisted the support of sympathetic young people to help keep a 24-hour guard on the nets of the Indian fishermen, because if the nets and boats were unguarded, they would be stolen by fishermen or destroyed by sportmen.
If you want something and if it's yours, you've got to fight to keep, and our people just aren't grasping this idea. They think that one of these days the government's going to feel sorry for them and give them what they want. This isn't so. So we have these young kids of today, they see what's happening to the Indians, so they come forward to offer their help, and we've accepted their help.
Fishermen and sheriff deputies came at night, making arrests and seizing nets, but the young people held on. As fall turned into winter, they built temporary shelters and lived in them. Buffy St. Marie visit the encampment. Dramatize the fishing rights.
He did, dear man, and the treaty's being broken by Kim Jordan. And what will you do for these ones? Oh, all in the past you can say, but it's still going on here today. The government now wants dearest more land back.